Your soul is leaving clues for you to help you understand what it yearns for. And when you bring your human being self into remembrance of, yes, I am a human being, but who I really am before I came here is a soul. Who I will be when my body is gently laid aside at the end of this life is a soul. And while I am here, I am still soul. I am filled with the living, loving light of the universe, God, creator, divinity. The entire time I'm here, my job is to wake up inside the dream. And when I wake up inside the dream and I realize, oh, I'm not here to play by society's rules of you should do this and you should do that and everyone should be in a cookie cutter box and doing the same things, be educated the same way, do the jobs that everyone tells you to do, follow XYZ authoritarian structures. No, 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 no. You are a free spirit. You have a unique makeup. You love certain kinds of environments. You have a certain kind of emotional system, certain kind of sensitivities. You have certain kinds of joys and passions and curiosities and interests. You love certain things. You don't love other things. And your job is to wake up and remember these things. And when you curate your life to your unique way, to what makes your heart sing, to what feels good and right for you, you will feel fulfilled and you will thrive. But it is a holy and beautiful thing in this world to be that courageous, outrageous, to go, I am going to curate my life exactly the way I want it. Not the way anyone taught me to do, not the way that my upbringing taught me, not the way that the government tells me, not the way that, you know, I'm taught by social media, not the way the advertisers are telling me. None of it. Not the way my friends are living, not the way my whatever, my partner tells me. There is a sovereignty that needs to arise at some point in your life where you go, I am who I am, and this is what I'm about, and I don't know why, and I'm going to honor it.
You're listening to Practical Spirituality with B, the podcast with spiritual advice for your everyday life, helping you align with your soul so you can live with purpose, fulfillment, and magic. I'm Bernadette Logue. You can call me B, and I'm excited to share this episode with you.
Welcome. How are you? I'm excited to be here with you for this episode. I thought, why not do a really light topic, like the big existential question, how do I find fulfillment in my life? It's been almost a year since we started the podcast, and we talked really early on in episodes 1 and 2 of this podcast, almost a year ago, about your soul plan and your soul purpose. And it feels like a really important time to circle back for people that are new to this work and new to this podcast to talk about fulfillment in life, because essentially most people land here with me in this body of work. I've been doing this for 12, 13, nearly 14 years, and most people land with me here because there is a lack of fulfillment. And whether that's showing up as life challenges, whether it's a void inside, whether it's wanting to achieve some kind of goal outside of us, quite often the common thread is we're seeking a greater sense of fulfillment. And so the foundation of this work that I do to support you is waking you up inside the dream of life, for you to recognize that you are more than this body and more than this mind and the noise going on in your mind, and you are more than the emotions that you are having, and you are greater than the experiences that you have had in the past. You are greater than the circumstances of your life, and you are not here on the planet for no reason. You are not random, and your life is not random. And when you awaken to who you really are, and what you're really doing here on the planet, and you start to connect the dots of the fact that you are a soul and you are wired with a blueprint for you to be experiencing, learning, growing, and contributing certain things on this life journey, then fulfillment is a flowing consequence of understanding those things. Because if you don't know who you are, then that's very confusing and you're not going to have fulfillment. If you don't understand what makes you tick and what is vital as lifeblood for you to breathe and feel and expand and have joy in your life, then you're not going to have fulfillment. If you ignore those things, you're not going to have fulfillment. And, you know, it's really easy on our life journey to get lost in doing what society tells you to do and doing what you have to do to get by in this world and doing what other people want you to do, doing what your parents taught you to do. And often what happens is in your, you know, 20s and in your 30s, particularly, you can kind of get away with doing anything in life and getting some level of fulfillment. Because what you'll do is you'll get an education, you'll, you know, get a career, you'll get a job, you'll start making money, you'll save, you'll get some things that you want to get. You do all the things that everyone tells you to do. You might then have a relationship, you might get married, you might have kids. And you're ticking off the boxes of things that society has told you will make you fulfilled. But when you get into your 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, if you've done all those things and you weren't in alignment with your true self, your soul, and you weren't able to be and do the true soulful yearnings from within you, then it is going to become very apparent. And it will show up as, oh, this career is not fulfilling me. I've gone wrong somewhere along the way. Or these relationships are not fulfilling me. Something isn't right here. Or I've done all the things that everybody says to do and I don't feel fulfilled inside. Or, oh, my life looks really great on the surface and I've got all these things and I've done what everybody is doing, but I feel empty. What's wrong with me? Or you know, you go seeking outside of you for more. I'll get more achievements, rewards, recognition, career, money, travel, lifestyle, whatever. And then you find out you still don't feel fulfilled. And it's not that any of the things are wrong. It's not that anything you've done was not the right thing to do. And it's not that any of those things that we can choose to do that end up not being fulfilling, it's not that you've taken a wrong path. It's just that you're a unique soul and there's something specific that is yearning to be met. And if it doesn't get met, it equals feeling unfulfilled. And so there's another aspect of this as well, and that is when we are chained down and weighed down with baggage, that can also make it harder for us to find a level of fulfillment. So we may be on track and in alignment with the yearnings of our heart, of our soul, but we're carrying so much baggage, it's like trudging through life. And so that makes it hard to just feel any joy and contentment from what we are being and doing in the world. So at a foundational level, you want to know this, the answers for your fulfillment are inside of you, not outside of you, and your soul leaves clues to help you understand what is fulfilling to you uniquely. Okay, and I'm going to give you some tips around that. When we come into life, we come to learn, to grow, to heal, and to make a contribution into the world. And we choose to come into this world and we choose to be the individual unique human being that we are. We are wired in very unique ways. There are certain things that we love. There are certain things we don't love. There are certain things that light us up, that other things that don't. There are certain ways of being and moving in the world, certain environments, activities, tasks, interests, topics that uniquely are curious and compelling or passionate and inspiring for us that are totally not for other people. And these things are often so overlooked and dismissed and denied by people while they're busy out there seeking for something else. It's like it's right under your nose, but you're not giving it the time of day. You're not giving it the curiosity, the willingness to explore it, to recognize how important it is for you, okay? The thing with your soulful yearning is this, it will never leave you alone, ever, okay? So what you are wired for within, the things that light you up, the things that make you passionate, the things that are important to you, the things that will get you out of bed every day, the things that make you feel like time disappears when you're doing them, engaging with them, Those things will never leave you, but they can very easily get buried deep down where you forget about them because life has become heavy or distracting, or you've gone down some path where you've hardly even recall what those things are for you, but they will never leave you alone. So if we excavate them and we go on a treasure hunt to find them within you, it doesn't take long once you touch on those or you scratch the surface for them to come back to life, okay? And for you to remember, have a remembrance about those parts of yourself. Now, you could be in one of multiple places. You could have never touched on the things that your soulful yearnings are, but we can still find them. Or they could have been alive and well earlier in your life, but you got distracted or lost or off down a path, and you've got to go back and collect those parts of yourself. And also there could be things in you that are soulful yearnings that are uncharted territory. So it's like a whole new dimension you're going to go forward into your life and start exploring. Here are the quickest ways to start to identify them, okay? And if you've been in my community for a while, you'll know these three things. They're a foundation in my book, Your Soul Journey Simplified. I talked about them often. They are passion, inspirations, and intuition, okay? Your passions, inspirations, and your intuition are the way that your soul speaks through you and to you in a language that you can understand, the language of feeling. You do not choose what you're passionate about, it chooses you. You do not make inspirations happen inside of you. They are things that come to you through your soulful self and then into your awareness, your mind, your being for you to recognize and do something with. And you do not make your intuition happen. It's happening through you as your sixth sense, as a way that you can learn to navigate this world. If you follow like a trail of breadcrumbs, your passions, your inspirations, and your intuition, they will lead you into fulfillment. But here is the thing. Most people deny, downplay, and doubt their passions, inspirations, and intuition. And so while your soul whispers to you things that are fulfilling for you to be and do and experience and explore and play with in the world, if your rational mind and your limiting beliefs and your fears get in the way, you may do things like overlook your passions, inspirations, and intuition, doubt them, downplay them, second guess them, say it can't be that, say it's not important, say, well, that's not going to give me XYZ in the world, so why would I bother? And also, if you don't know what you're going to get, like if you're like, I need to get something from everything I do, I need to get recognition, I need to get money, I need to get XYZ from anything I do, then you won't go exploring because you won't be able to see with your logical mind how playing with your passions, inspirations, and intuition, you won't be able to map it out and see how is that going to get me further in life. We're not trying to get something. We are choosing things that bring us in the moment a sense of fulfillment. And footnote to that is when you do that, your life begins to synchronistically unfold and you might be surprised what beautiful things you do get, like whole new careers or businesses or opportunities, or amazing things can come from what I call pulling the threads of your passions, inspirations, and intuitions when you've only got an inkling, when it's only a tiny little twinkle in your eye of an idea, when it's only a somewhat interesting, a little bit curious something inside of you, and you'll go, well, it's not like a giant passion. That's why people get stuck, is they completely misinterpret what passion is. Often it's just an initial curiosity that you pull the thread of, right? It doesn't have to be some gigantic obsession in your life that you begin to engage with. So when you want to find fulfillment, you want to know this. There has to be an alignment with that heart-led level of you, which is your soulful self, the part of you that came into this world to dance and play with life, that is beyond your logical mind that is beyond what society says. Your soul is like, I want what I want. I came here for this. And if I'm not able to express myself in this way, then I will be in lack of fulfillment. And it will feel like a void inside emotionally. It will feel like confusion in the mind. And so the easiest way, again, to tune into what does my soul want is to notice, what are your passions or curiosities, interests? What are your inspirations and what is your intuition telling you? Another way that you can start to tune into your soulful self and what is important for you for fulfillment is to look at your values. Your values are soulful, okay? You don't choose your values. You didn't enter the world and go, I'm going to be really passionate about social justice. Or, you know, environmental issues are really important to me and I've just decided to make that important to me with my mind. I've just made up that idea. No, you have like a heart-led passion for it. You're inspired about it and your intuition keeps nudging you to do things in that area. Or say you've got a value around compassion, kindness, and supporting people. That is a very specific kind of person. That is a values base and that is from your soul. You don't wake up one day and go, well, I think I'm just going to go and make that my life value and my personal, you know, my personal plan for my life. It's a part of you. You go and ask people that are doing work with animals, you know, how long in your life have you been interested in animals? Most of them will say since they were children. Go and ask people that are into environmental care or social justice or, you know, healing and coaching. How long have you been interested in helping people? How long has the environment interested you? Most people are going to say, you know what, it's been something that's been kind of seeded in me and it's always been there. Or it really awoke for me when I was in my teens or my 20s. And it's not something that you can get away from. It's like it's in you and it won't leave you alone, right? But I often hear people say, I don't have something like that. But what's happened is they're really in their mind and they're not willing to really get into their heart and let themselves really feel what's important to them. Because society trains us, get a career. If you can't make money from it, don't waste your time with it. I'm too busy doing this. I'm too busy doing that. You know, people out there that are really fulfilled, well, they're doing really big things. So my little thing, like my passion for gardening or my passion for writing or my passion for listening to music or whatever it is, well, that can't be important because that's not some big mission. Your soul is not interested in that. Your soul is interested in expressing and playing and having fun and exploring and being curious. And that's what that part of you wants. And that might be collecting vinyl records from back in the day. It might be exploring different culinary, you know, ways of cooking. It might be, you know, exploring cutting edge ways of educating children. It could be understanding how machinery works and how cars and equipment work. Whatever it is that lights you up, it might be exploring the history of the dinosaur era or goodness knows what, right? But your soul has interests. And it wants to play with them, full stop. And you will find fulfillment when you give yourself permission to play for the sake of playing, to explore for the sake of exploring, to be curious for the sake of being curious, and not to judge, label, try to make it something or get something from it. And that doesn't mean you won't get something from it. You're going to get fulfillment to start. You're probably going to meet amazing people and have amazing experiences because that's what happens when you get in your soul lane and you play with life. And who knows what may come of it for opportunities, career, business, or other things if you want that to be a part of your pathway. So one resource that you can go and get immediately if you're like, I need to understand my soul, I need to understand why I came into this life, and I want to attune to what is going to be uniquely fulfilling for me at a very deep, soulful heart level, like a sense of meaning, a sense of purpose, a sense of I understand why I'm here and I am connected with something that's greater than me, go and grab my book. You can go to my website, www.bernadettelogue.com. I've got 4 books, but get my latest book, which is Your Soul Journey Simplified. Just click book on the top menu. You can instantly download it on my website and you'll be able to get started right away. If you want it in paperback, you can go to Amazon. That book will step you through it and it'll give you a much bigger picture, way more detailed than just we can cover in this episode. It's going to give you your soul plan, your soul purpose, a sense about contribution. It's going to give you the 11 stages of your soul journey from birth to transition and how purpose and fulfillment fits inside of that journey. So it's a really powerful resource. It's the quickest, easiest way to get into working with me. If you want more, then come and join me. The next step is and come into the Soul Odyssey community with live support and a step-by-step program that you come through with me. We have a beautiful group environment. You can learn at your own pace. You can engage as much or as little as you want. And you get live support in that group environment with me. And we put fulfillment in the context of your entire journey on the planet. Like, who am I? Why am I here? What's going on? How do I align with my soul? How do I live my purpose? How do I have fulfillment? And how do I fill my life with magic, miracles, synchronicities, and all the good things? And then for those that want to go even further, I work one-on-one with people where I will help you get deeply into your alignment, okay? And we will look at exactly what you need to do in your unique situation to bring you into alignment at all the levels of your life so you can be fully and utterly connected at your soul level, at the level of Source, Creator, Divinity, Universe, and really thrive in all areas of your life for the level of fulfillment that you want. So there's different levels that you can come in at. I recommend to get started that you get the book, Your Soul Journey Simplified. And really, when you think about it, when you're looking for fulfillment in your life, if you're on a spiritual path and a personal growth path, and you've done any level of exploration about understanding who you are and why you're here and how to get fulfillment, you will know that all cultures, all faiths, and all religions all point to the same kinds of messages. And if you go exploring in what people might call New Age, but is actually ancient timeless wisdom, things like your full numerology chart, your birth chart for your astrology, you go looking at your Akashic records of your soul history, it will all point to pretty much the same core things. They will come at it from different angles, but what they do is they illuminate the same underlying messages. We are not of this place. We are souls and we are incarnated here. We are timeless and forever the loving energy of the universe. We have come forth to play, to evolve, to have this evolutionary experience as human beings. You have a plan and you have a purpose for being here. And what I love about the frameworks that I work with and why I feel it's so powerfully effective for people, after being on a personal growth journey since I was about 18 or 19, I'm about to turn 46, and after being deep down the rabbit hole of spirituality for the last 13, 14 years, is that you can actually see your soul's plan and purpose playing out in the events of your life, leaving actual tangible footprints in the events of your life, inside your relationships, in your past, in your present circumstances, inside your heart and inside your feeling system. Your soul has leaving clues for you to help you understand what it yearns for. And when you bring your human being self into remembrance of, yes, I am a human being, but who I really am before I came here is a soul. Who I will be when my body is gently laid aside at the end of this life is a soul. And while I am here, I am still soul. I am filled with the living, loving light of the universe, God, Creator, Divinity. The entire time I'm here, my job is to wake up inside the dream. And when I wake up inside the dream and I realize, oh, I'm not here to play by society's rules of you should do this and you should do that and everyone should be in a cookie cutter box and doing the same things, be educated the same way, do the jobs that everyone tells you to do, follow XYZ authoritarian structures. No, 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 no. You are a free spirit. You have a unique makeup. You love certain kinds of environments. You have a certain kind of emotional system, certain kind of sensitivities. You have certain kinds of joys and passions and curiosities and interests. You love certain things. You don't love other things. And your job is to wake up and remember these things. And when you curate your life to your unique way, to what makes your heart sing, to what feels good and right for you, you will feel fulfilled and you will thrive. But it is a holy and beautiful thing in this world to be that courageous, outrageous, to go, I am going to curate my life exactly the way I want it. Not the way anyone taught me to do, not the way that my upbringing taught me, not the way that the government tells me, not the way that, you know, I'm taught by social media, not the way the advertisers are telling me. None of it. Not the way my friends are living, not the way my whatever, my partner tells me. There is a sovereignty that needs to arise at some point in your life where you go, I am who I am, and this is what I'm about, and I don't know why, and I'm going to honor it. Like, for example, some funny things, right? I didn't particularly love going and doing certain social things, but I would make myself do them because that's what everybody does. Oh, you get to a certain age and you're like, nope, I'm not about it. So I had this funny joke with a friend once. I was like, please don't invite me out to dinner anymore because I don't like to go out of the house like after 9 o'clock at night. Like when the sun goes down, you'll find me in my pajamas at home where I feel cozy and I'm not about it. I don't like going out late at night, and that's how it is. And so I no longer will go out and do things at night if I don't want to go out and do them. And it sounds like a really silly thing, but when you try to permanently fit yourself into boxes because it's the right thing to do or other people say you should do it, then you end up just living this false life, right? Or say you like to have a lot of time alone and you feel like you have to justify it to other people. Stop justifying it. Curate your life to make the amount of time alone that you need. Negotiate it with your partner or your children or your boss or whoever you have to do it with. If that is what you need, like if you're an introvert or you're an HSP, highly sensitive person, you curate your life to suit you. You do life in the way that makes you feel lit up and happy and joyous. Like for me, when I was like, you know what? I don't want to work in a corporate job anymore. I don't want to do that. I want to work wherever I want to work. I want to work when I want to work. And to me at the time, it sounded a bit outrageous. Like, can I actually be that ballsy and that bold? And I was like, it's just what I want to do. I want to work at home. I don't want to get in a car and drive and commute. I want to keep as much of my time for myself. And I want to just follow my curiosities. And if I had not given myself permission to follow my inspirations, my intuition, my passions, and listen to the yearnings inside my heart, I would have followed the same path I was on, and I was unfulfilled. I had a big void inside. I felt empty. And I was like, something is not right. And the something that was not right is I had not curated my life to suit my unique need. And my soul has a very specific need for freedom in very specific ways. And then once I curated my life around that, and don't get me wrong, it took some effort to figure out how to do that. But once I did, that fulfillment arose, right? And so I've been able to curate a life where I can live anywhere in the world. I do my work from wherever I want in the world. I do it when I want to do it. I have a lot of freedom from that point of view. And it did not just happen. Fulfillment didn't just land on my doorstep. I went, what is not fulfilling about my life? What would be fulfilling? What if I could like curate my life any way I wanted to be, what would it look like? And the life that I have now has been very specifically designed, right? And often when I sit with people and they're saying to me, you know, I've got a void inside, I'm not fulfilled, I don't know what my purpose is, the mind wants to say that. But when you scratch the surface of, you know, what are your dreams? What did you dream of as a child? If you could have it, life be the way you wanted it to be and you could have anything you wanted, what would it be? It's not long before it starts pouring out people's mouths. But we don't often let ourselves go there because we don't want to get disappointed. It feels too big. It feels too hard. Our fears get in the way. It feels risky. It feels uncertain. We would have to do things we're not familiar with doing. You know, it's inconvenient. I love this quote from Coot Blackson. I've heard him say a couple of times in different forms, you know, following your soul's calling or your soul's path is inconvenient and uncomfortable. And I put that quote in my book, Your Soul Journey Simplified, because it's just like so true. You talk to anyone who has found fulfillment by listening to their soulful self, and they will be like, yeah, it was pretty inconvenient to have to listen to that, because it means you have to change some stuff. Like, you might look and go, I'm not in the right career. Or, you know what? My business is not the business. Or, you know what? I don't fit in this circle of friends, and I haven't for a long time, and they're legacy relationships, and I don't know where my people are. Or, you know what? I do not like the way I spend my life, Saturday to Sunday, Monday to Friday, routine, none of it really works for me. Because what it's left with is, I know what is not working, but I do not know how to change it to what I want. That, you don't even go there. Like, don't even start with that. Just start by acknowledging, what do I yearn for? What is missing? Is it more connected relationships? Is it more self-expression? Is it that you're a singer and a dancer and you're not doing any of those things? Is it that you long to be free and you feel completely trapped in the lifestyle that you have? Is it that you always actually wanted to be an architect, but you ended up becoming a landscape gardener and you're in the wrong space? You have to be willing to admit it to yourself. And once you can voice it and allow yourself to dream and vision, then the shifts can begin to happen. And here's the other thing to remember. When you want to find fulfillment, the answers to fulfillment are inside you, so we don't have to go far to look for it. But then once you have it, you are also not alone in figuring out, how do I now do something with this? How do I change the relationships, the career, the lifestyle, the business, the way I do my routine? People often get stuck at that. I don't know how I would change. Okay, number one is, you're smarter than you give yourself credit for. And in 5 minutes, I could have you with an action plan to take you at least for the next couple of months towards what you want. Number two is that there is answers to literally everything. You are in the age of information. You can have it at your fingertips. If you want to find it, you will find it. People that have a will find a way. Okay, so how important is fulfillment to you? Ask yourself the deathbed question. Am I willing to, at the end of my life, saying I coulda, shoulda, woulda, but I didn't because I couldn't figure it out, when actually I could have figured it out? Okay. Number three, get yourself a coach. That's what we're here for. That's why we're amazing at our jobs, and that's why people come to us, because we help you map it. Because sometimes you're too close to yourself to see it clearly, and you're not as objective. The saying is, I can't see the wood for the trees, okay? And then the fourth thing is this. What would make you think that you would be alone in trying to figure this out and make it happen for yourself to find your fulfillment, when you are not a mind and body, you are not a small person, and you are not a separate little body alone on this planet? You are a soul, and as a soul, you are an extension of source, or what we may call God, creator, divinity, universe, one consciousness, loving energy. That is the substance of all creation. And it gave life and expression to you as a soul, and your soul is currently poured into this reality, having a human being experience. You are literally connected to all of creation. It is flowing through you, in you. What would make you think, therefore, that you are alone? You cannot possibly be alone. Life is constantly conjuring and responding to your direction and your desire and where you want to go. You have free will. Life and spirit or guides or divine guidance will not intercede and will not intervene against your free will. But the moment you stand up and go, I've remembered who I am, I know what lights me up, I'm about it, and I want help, and you put all your belief, thought, feeling, and your action in that direction, the energy that you put into life is mirrored back to you, and you start to experience synchronicities, signs, miracles, openings. Beautiful things begin to happen, but we have to get awake. We have to get remembering who we are. reconnected to what is most important to us at a deeper soulful level, the yearnings of our hearts, our passions, inspirations, intuitions, our values. And then we have to say, I'm about it. And I want to start to realign myself and my life to this beautiful level of fulfillment. Okay? Don't forget, the book, Your Soul Journey Simplified, can help you get a really good foundational understanding of all of this stuff. Two, if you want a resource that is going to give you everything you need with live support from me and an amazing community of people from all over the world who are all very like-minded, extremely loving and supportive, then you want to come and join the Soul Odyssey community with live support and a comprehensive program that takes you step by step through literally everything that I've mentioned in this episode. And then if you also want to have personalized, deeper support, I take a small number of people each month for one-on-one with me. That option is also on my website. So you can go to www.bernadettelogue.com. You'll see book, program, and coaching on the menu. You can click any one of those to find out about the thing that resonates most with you. I'm excited to connect with you if you're coming over and being a part of it all. And I look forward to sharing another episode with you really soon.
Thanks for listening to Practical Spirituality with Bee. I'll talk to you next episode for more spiritual advice for your everyday life, helping you align with your soul so you can live with purpose, fulfillment, and magic.